Hello and welcome to Loving Tech Life. This is a quick start guide to get you up and playing some retro games in RetroArch on your iPad, iPhone or Apple TV devices. RetroArch can be overwhelming when you first start it up with all the options it has available. If you want to get in and start playing some games quickly, then you're in the right place. Stick around to the end for a few extra tips and basic setup options, but with that said, let's get into it. To start, we're going to the App Store and typing RetroArch in the search, and then select Get to install it. While that's downloading, you can go in and select More here to expand out to the description and see all the systems that RetroArch for iOS currently supports. We have various cores or emulators for microcomputers from Amstrad and Commodore, various Atari consoles including the 2600 and the handheld Atari Lynx, NEC's PC Engine, various Nintendo consoles from NES and handhelds to SNES and N64, Neo Geo and Sega and Sony consoles up to the Sega Saturn and Sony PlayStation 1 and everything in between. Once RetroArch has been installed, we go back to the home screen and open RetroArch for the first time so it downloads some assets. And then we're going to select the online updater here and select each of the options below to update the various things available to the latest versions. On the right hand side, you'll see the navigation options for RetroArch. At the top you have Home, then Playlists is the three line icon, and the cog is for settings. There are a lot of options and settings you can play with in RetroArch, but we're going to go straight to getting some games imported and up and running. To do this, we'll need to go back to the home screen and select the Files app. On the left here, select On My iPad, then find the RetroArch folder, and again select RetroArch. In here is where we need to copy any games, and the system folder here is where any BIOS files go. Systems like the PlayStation that we'll take a look at will need BIOS files. Using the Files app, there are a number of ways we can import games to the iOS device's RetroArch folder. You can upload them from your PC or Mac to iCloud and copy them over from iCloud here. You could use a third-party cloud storage like Dropbox or G Drive in the same way. You could transfer them from a Mac or PC over cable or Wi-Fi. Lastly, you can use external storage and transfer them over that way. Since I have a USB-C external drive ready to go, I'm going to use that for this tutorial. Here, you can see I've plugged in my Samsung T7 SSD. I'll go in there and you can see I've already created a folder called ROMs where I've stored all my games that I'm going to transfer over. I can't tell you where to find the games or BIOS files, but Google search is your friend here. To copy this over, just long press on the folder and select copy. Then go back to the RetroArch folder in On My iPad. And since there isn't a folder already for storing games, we're just going to scroll down to the bottom and long press at the bottom in the white space here and select paste. Now that it's finished transferring everything over, we'll have a quick look inside. To keep everything organized, I have created a folder for each system and put the games in there. I've also created a separate BIOS folder so it was easy to find. Since the BIOS files need to be located in the system folder, I'm going to copy those over first by clicking select at the top and selecting each of the three BIOS files. Then by selecting more on the bottom right and copy three items. Navigating back to the On My iPad section and to the RetroArch folder again, I scroll down to system and long press and select paste to get them into the system folder. Going back to the ROMs folder quickly, you can see how I created folders for each of these different consoles, and opening the Genesis one, you can see I have just a small selection of games here for this video. Now I'm going to delete the PSX BIOS folder by long pressing on the folder because I have already copied them to the system folder where they belong. All required BIOS files for various systems go into that folder. Next we're going to go back to RetroArch and load up the games in the most streamlined way to access and play them. So in RetroArch, we select the three line icon on the right, which is the playlist menu. Then import content at the top and scan directory at the top. Select the folder that appears. I'm going to scroll down to the ROMs folder we copied in and select scan this directory here. This is going to scan all the games I have in folders, Game Boy Advance, Genesis or Mega Drive, PC Engine, PSX or PlayStation, Sega Master System and Super NES. It creates playlists and even downloads artwork for you. You can see it found 105 games. Once it has finished scanning, you can go back to the beginning of the playlist menu by selecting the three lines playlist menu on the right hand side. Here you can scroll down and you'll find playlists for the systems you just imported games for. Now you can go into a playlist, select a game and start playing. Here I select the Sega Mega Drive Genesis playlist. Scroll down and choose Gunstar Heroes. Most systems will have multiple cores or emulators to choose from, so here I'm just going to choose Genesis plus GX. Then run at the top and the game will start. By default, there are on-screen controls that work well enough, but you can easily set up an external controller, which I'll show you how to do next. To leave the game, just select the RetroArch button on the bottom right and it will take you to the home menu. From here, you can select Close Content to stop the game. Here, I have a PS5 controller, but you can use any Bluetooth controller you have. Close out of RetroArch and go into Settings, then Bluetooth, and put it into pairing mode by holding the Create and PlayStation buttons until the light starts flashing like this. Then select it on the iPad and it will pair. Now, when you're back in RetroArch, it will just start working. You can navigate back to the playlist and choose a game and run, and it will control the game. If you're using a controller, you can remove the on-screen controls by selecting the down arrow on the right-hand side here. You can completely remove the on-screen controls so the small arrow icon is not on the screen, since the DualSense controller can bring the home menu up by pressing the PlayStation button by default. To remove it, go to Settings, User Interface, and scroll down to the on-screen overlay, and turn off Display Overlay. Now, while you're in game, it won't show any overlay and you can get back to the home screen with the PS button. If you don't have a PlayStation controller, you will want to set up a shortcut to the home screen menu, which I'll show you shortly. The iPad screen was made for retro gaming as it's so close to the 4:3 aspect ratio, so it fills the screen. Once you have a controller set up, you may want to set up a nicer interface that's more controller friendly compared to the touchscreen one you can see here. Select the settings cog on the right, then scroll down to drivers, select Menu, then choose the XMB option at the bottom. For the changes to take effect, you need to restart RetroArch. When you open it back up, it will have the XMB interface, which is like the original PlayStation 3 menu system. This makes it a lot easier to navigate with a controller and looks a lot nicer with the playlist displaying the artwork. By default, the external controller has the RetroArch menu button swapped to match the Nintendo layout, and if you prefer to have it reversed to match the PlayStation and Xbox layout so the button selects things, then go to Settings, Input, scroll down to Menu Controls, and then go to Menu Swap OK and Cancel buttons, which I find more intuitive. I mentioned earlier that you can set a shortcut to get back from the game to the menu if you have removed all the on-screen controls. So with your controller, you will want to set a controller combo shortcut to get back to the menu if you're using different controllers. To do this, go to Settings, Input, Hotkeys, Menu Toggle Controller Combo. Here I just choose L3 and R3. Now, while in game, I can press L3 and R3 buttons together, or the PS button to get back to the menu. I had some trouble getting RetroArch scanning and creating a playlist automatically for the PlayStation games, maybe because of the CHD file type I was using, so I want to show you how to manually create a playlist. I was able to manually choose and play each game in the menu, but I wanted a playlist with artwork to be created like the rest. Go to the Import or Plus icon here and scroll down to Manual Scan. In System Name, navigate to Sony PlayStation and select it. Then select Content Directory, RetroArch, and scroll to the ROMs folder, then PSX, and choose Scan This Directory. Then you can scroll down and select Start Scan. After I did this, the PlayStation playlist was created with the artwork and I could play the games from here. One last tip in case the games you have are not working, you can check which file types each core works with by selecting Load Core, then choose one of the cores or emulators from the list. I'm going to choose a PlayStation core, then scroll down to Information and Core Information, and you can see all the files extensions that the core supports like Q, PPP, and CHD. So if a game is not working for you, you may need to check here to see if the game is in the right format that works with the core. Below that are listed all the BIOS that are required or optional and if they are missing or present. After following this guide, you'll now be able to play thousands of games across all the systems currently available in RetroArch on your iPhone, iPad, or Apple TV devices. Obviously, there's a lot more tinkering you can do with it, as it's a very comprehensive app with a lot of options and flexibility. This is just a quick start guide to get you up and playing some games with some basic options. Thank you for watching, and if this video helps you out, please go ahead and smash the like button below, and I'll see you in the next one.